Hello, everyone. This is Jesse Jackson. Not only am I one of the hosts of How Many, but I am also the guy that goes in and tries to edit our conversation. We had a slight technical difficulty with our last episode, and so I'm having to re-edit the Arnold podcast, and that's the one you're going to hear now. And then next week, we have the second half of our music discussion. We talked Lionel Richie and the Commodores, and then we talked Glen Campbell, so we decided to split these in two. The Glen Campbell episode will be out next week. Thank you for downloading it. Please let us know what you think. We want to hear from you. Let me hear from you, whether you got big boobs or not. Oh, sorry, ticket reference.
It might be a tumor.
It's not a tumor. It's not a tumor at all.
How many? How many? How many? How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Who? Hee! Ho! Fa! Hee! Hee! Ha! All right. What did I get up to?
Hello, and welcome to a new episode of How Many, your podcast all about pop culture, movies, TVs, films, and we discuss, the three of us, what is significant and what isn't. I am one of your hosts, Jesse Jackson. Joining me, as always, is...
Sideshow Bob.
And Mexican Junior.
All right. Hey, so guys, I understand tonight we've got a movie discussion.
Yes. Now, before we get to the topic, do you guys want to discuss any movies we've seen recently? I know I just got done, and Bob was there too. We just got done watching Atomic Blonde this month.
Yeah.
Thumbs up. Big thumbs up. Great soundtrack.
Yeah, soundtrack
was excellent.
Like
gay Euro 80s music, which I adore.
Any 80s pop hit that had German in it is in that movie.
Yeah.
So Der Kommissar, check. 99 Left Balloons, check. Major Tom, check.
Nice.
In addition to Atomic Blonde, a couple of weeks before that, I watched War for the Planet of the Apes. Okay. Thought that was an excellent movie. Me and Bob are both big fans of Bad Ape.
That's the best part of that movie is Bad Ape.
Yeah, he has
Steve
so
Zahn,
much shake.
Yeah, Steve Zahn does the voice.
I've read a couple of people that I admire that say that it's the best of the three, and normally
I would agree with that.
That if you know that usually as the X-Men movie talked about the third movie of any sequel sucks, you know, and they mentioned that joke in the third X-Men movie.
My favorite is still the very, very original 69, 68
sure.
one, but yeah,
the
Charlton
old
Heston.
One.
Yes, greatness.
So many plastic.
Damn you all to hell.
CGI on that was
I love
so
every ape I see from chimpan A to chimpan Z.
All right, Dr. Zayas.
Dr. Zayas.
So at the beginning of the month also, I think we all mixed in Spider-Man Homecoming. Did you see
I
that
have
one
not
yet?
Seen Spider-Man
Whoa,
Homecoming
big blow.
Wow.
Well,
turning your back on your comic.
No, I had bought tickets and Clayton and I were going to go, and it was the Friday night after a chemo treatment, and I was just too sick to go. And then some big family obligations, so I'm feeling bad. Though I have seen two older movies on via the miracle of HBO and On Demand, and The Accountant.
Yeah,
yeah, Ben Affleck
really
movie.
Good.
Yes,
movie.
Except for the ending, which I thought was so stupid.
No,
but
I like
the whole whenever he meets up with Shane from Walking Dead at the end, and all of a sudden, oh hey bro, hey, let's go get lunch later.
Spoiler!
I knew that was coming because you kept seeing the brothers, so I thought that was. I kind of saw that.
Yeah,
so
I kind of figured
to see
it out too.
And then I really liked the lady from the Americans.
Oh.
You know, playing the
which
autistic.
I have yet to see. Is that a big must see?
Yes,
with the Americans?
The Americans.
Big must see.
It's really well done, but man, it's hard. It's dense, man. It's hard to get through. I've stalled out a couple times. Not because it's bad, but it's just kind of overload.
It
sometimes.
It is not something you can like try to do more than one thing at a time. Like you know, sometimes you can just have
too much detail.
Like Ballers.
I can just check email and watch that.
It's a lot of detail, and it's really hard to binge because it's exhausting watching that show. But it's really well done.
It is well done, and it is. And the other one I saw is the Jack Reacher sequel. I really liked the
Jack
first
Reacher
one.
Around. Very
and,
nice.
Yes, and I liked it too.
The first one was better than the second one.
I would agree with that. The second one was still good though, and I think. You know, and
it has the chick from the Marvel movies, the Avengers lady, the one that was in
Kobe's
Oh, I Met Your Mother.
Yeah, but
so future
the
topic,
chick from the first one's even hotter.
Yeah, Tom Cruise.
The lady from Gone Girl.
A future discussion of Tom Cruise, how many?
By the way, last night I saw a Tom Cruise movie because I took my kids to the dollar movie and we saw The Mummy.
And?
Pretty spare.
Yeah, that's...
But there was... It had more comic... elements to it than I expected going in.
Okay.
And I realized after the movie that I cannot tell the difference between Jake Johnson and Oscar Isaac.
I read that tweet.
I thought it was the whole movie, I thought it was Oscar Isaac, and then it turned out it was Jake Johnson. Jake Johnson's the guy from New Girl. Oscar Isaac's the guy from Star Wars.
Oh, the pilot that had the little robot. Okay.
They look exactly alike, man.
Kind of, sort of.
No.
Since I'm an avid New Girl P1, I know that's SG, but I could tell the difference.
But he was all zombied up in The Mummy.
Yeah, you're right. That movie was kind of spare. It had some good action. It was a good doorway to what I assume is going to be the rest of the Dark World, Dark Universe series. Although this one flopped so bad.
Yeah.
Are they just going to cut bait and say, no more Invisible Man?
Was there too
no
much?
More Dr. Jekyll?
Yeah, was there too much Russell Crowe, Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde?
Yes. Stupid.
And then what creature did Tom Cruise turn into at the end? I didn't recognize what he was supposed to be. Was he like the Wolfman or something?
And the mummy chick was not very hot. And we saw her again in Atomic Blonde.
Yeah.
And she actually goes full whipping them out in that one. But there's not much to whip out. She was spare too. So overall, Mummy, probably thumbs down. I could be talked in that midway.
Download only.
Yeah, Cody only on that one. Okay, are we going live on...
We are. We are doing Facebook Live. Hello, everyone. This is a live recording of How Many Podcast.
So, are you on P1CR or are you on PP?
I am just doing on my page.
Oh,
we've got a few people.
Oh, panic.
So, Doctor Who and...
Yay, Springsteen.
Yeah, Bruce Buds.
Hello. Bruce Buds.
Every such. Okay, so, Junior, it is your topic.
Okay, so, the topic we are going to broach tonight is, how many does Arnold Schwarzenegger have?
He's not the Duma.
Now, Arnold Schwarzenegger has a very long and distinguished career.
Now, do we count him being Governor of California as one of his...
As one of his acting roles?
Yes.
If you would like, we can make that an honorary role. But for purposes of this discussion, we're going to look at his filmography, starting in 1969. And I kind of...
69? What was he in then?
We'll get to it. And then it kind of fiddles out around 2015.
All right, so I just was asked on the Facebook Live how many what. For those of you who have not ever joined the podcast before, our premise is we pick a pop culture figure, and then we don't know this in advance, and we go, how many significant / good films have they been in?
Or songs, or
whatever
books,
the culture,
or
yeah.
TV shows. It could broach a lot of different subjects.
Right.
So, before we start getting into the list, we all need to give our number. So,
right.
Jesse, how many would you say Arnold Schwarzenegger has?
So, there was a time when he was cranking out entertaining movies. So, I'm going to go 20.
Whoa, that's pretty high. Okay, Bob?
I was thinking close to that. I'll say 16.
Okay. Had I not done the research online ahead of time, I would have said... Close to Bob, I would have said about 15.
Okay.
But after doing the research, I found that my number was wee too low.
Okay. All
right. So you're saying there's something wrong with
there
our
is
estimates?
Definitely something wrong with our estimates.
Okay.
By the way, we can have fun with the wall doing green screen.
Yes.
The way it comes through
exactly.
You gotta see how it comes through on the.
Yeah, we could have like a hellfire or something.
Yeah,
like
the same reason that you shouldn't wear a green dress when you're doing a a White House briefing. So.
Ooh, we're up to four viewers.
Oh yay!
Oh yeah!
Awesome.
All right, so I'm going to go in chronological order here, and okay. we'll go through, and you can tell me whether you know this movie, whether you don't, and whether we should count it or not. So, starting off in 1969, I know that was a very long time ago. Were either of you born?
Yeah. At this time? No, Jesse was like in high school.
Oh, okay. This was like 50 years before I was born, so I can't relate to this movie. Hercules in New York is his first movie of his filmography, where he played the role of Hercules. Now, in this movie, he's actually credited as Arnold Strong instead of
Arnold. He should have stuck with that.
Instead of Arnold Schwarzenegger, and all of his lines in the movie dubbed over by an English actor. So, would you count that?
No.
No.
Okay, so that's
enough. I'm not counting that.
I thought his first movie was The Villain. I didn't know he did anything
before The
Villain.
No, I was going to guess because he's in that famous documentary.
Pumping Iron?
Yeah. Absolutely. So, yeah, we'll get into that one in a little bit. He was in a movie called The Long Goodbye. Do you guys remember him in that movie at all? No, then we will not count that one. It says he was a deaf and mute character in that one. Didn't have anything on script.
I cannot hear you.
Happy Anniversary and Goodbye, where he played somebody named Rico, Uncle
Rico.
So that's a no.
Rico Suave.
That was in 1974. Okay, so 1976, he was in a movie called Stay Hungry, which apparently got some good acclaim.
Sister album?
No. So in that movie, he played somebody named Joe Santo, and he actually won.
You were in the movie Santo.
Yeah, I was in the movie Santos, but I did not see Arnold Strong on set. apparently, he won a Golden Globe for Best New Star of the Year in that movie. So I didn't know if you guys had ever heard of that, seen it. Are we going to give that one a no? Even though he won a Golden Globe.
No.
You're still going to give it a no.
By the way, Greg Paula says, and I'm not sure which movie it is, but I love that. He goes, if you're going to count that one, we might as well give him credit for tripping over a curb. So, thank you, Greg.
Okay, so now we're probably going to get into one that he should get credit for, Pumping Iron, where he plays himself.
Yes.
And that was the documentary you were referring to,
yes.
where he's training to become Mr. Olympia or Mr. Universe, one of those movies. I have not seen that movie entirely, but I do know that it's significant.
Yeah.
So I would count that one.
I've never seen it, but I mean, you always talk about that's. I vaguely remember him being Hercules, you know, like when you see a documentary, but no, I definitely think this is.
Yeah.
Okay.
Back in the video rental days, I was very leery about taking a video called Pumping Iron to the register. Like,
very SG.
Yes.
So we'll go ahead and count Pumping Iron. And that was in 77. So now we're getting into 1979, and this is where the villain comes in that you had referenced earlier, where he plays Handsome Stranger.
Yeah, that movie had Anne Margaret and Kirk Douglas in it, and I think it was a silent movie. I don't think there was any dialogue in it.
Wasn't that kind of a live-action Roadrunner movie?
It really was with big giant fake boulders and
stuff.
Well, personally, I've never heard of it, but if you guys want to count it,
yeah, I would count it because I remember when I was a kid seeing that and thinking it was Shake Laugh. So
okay,
it's really stupid, but it's kind of like Caveman. Do you remember that Ringo Starr movie, Caveman?
Yes,
it's kind of like that
with all of the claymation of the dinosaurs and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the next movie he was in that same year was Scavenger Hunt, where he played somebody named Lars, I guess the drummer for Metallica. No dice. Okay. The Comeback, where he plays himself, which is also another documentary.
No.
All right, so now we are getting into the golden era of Arnold Schwarzenegger, starting in 1982 with the movie Conan the Barbarian.
Yes!
One of my favorite movies of the 80s. Would you agree, Bob?
I mean, I'll count it. I'm not a big, huge fan of
Conan.
How
could you not like Conan?
I don't dislike it. It's just, it's not a big, you know, high on my list.
No, I know you're SG.
No.
I remember going to that movie.
It's okay.
Thinking it was awesome.
You know, I actually think I saw that movie in the theater. That tells you how pumped my parents were for that movie, that they brought me
to it. I'm fine with it. I'm counting it.
And it does have a lot of new full frontal scenes and everything in it, especially in that scene where they're having the giant orgy and stuff and giant snake head man.
Was it him and Red Sonja having at it?
No, Red Sonja's later. We'll get to that one later. So, Conan the Barbarian.
This was
right?
role that made him a star.
Yeah.
Yes,
absolutely.
So that's a yes. So, getting into 1984 is the sequel to Conan the Barbarian, Conan the Destroyer. Now, that movie I did not necessarily think was that great, but should still count.
Yeah. Absolutely. It wasn't as good as often sequels aren't, but yes, I agree.
Yeah, Will Chamberlain was in it. Grace Jones was in it.
Yes.
Definitely an entertaining movie. I wouldn't necessarily say it's great. Bob, would you agree?
Yeah. And then my favorite one was the third one, Conan the Talk Show Host, which was really...
The show's hit a new low. We've all powdered down. Okay, so moving out on 1984, actually the same year, his next movie came out and probably is one of the movies that defines him in addition to Conan the Barbarian, which is The Terminator.
Definitely counts.
So, by
definitely
the way,
better than Conan.
Shout out to Cal, who I work with. She gave us a... Laugh out loud, your Conan the Talk Show.
Oh, awesome.
Oh, so, very nice.
Yes.
All
right.
So your audience reached one person.
Yes. Hey, but that one person, there we go.
Everybody else
you
is
need to
posting
screen grab that
a screenshot of a cricket. Okay, so The Terminator, obviously that one does count,
yes,
right?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, so going into 1985, a movie that Bob referenced a little while ago, Red Sonja,
yes,
where he plays Kalidor. And Red Sonja was played by Brigitte Nielsen, I want to say.
I think so.
Okay, so that one was kind of a sequel or a continuation of the Conan movies, but he wasn't playing Conan, so it was kind of confusing. He wasn't really playing the same character, but it was that same medieval times kind of deal. Would you count Red Sonja? He was only in the movie like maybe half the time.
I think no.
I mean, it's not... It's not really a Schwarzenegger movie. He's in it, but
kind of just the supporting cameo kind of role. I could be talked out of it, so I could say no too. So let's say no on that one. To balance out the numbers, we'll say no.
Okay.
All right, so staying in 1985, his next movie, and which is one that I like as well, because it has the great Alyssa Milano in it. Commando.
Wait, I thought Radon Chong was in Commando.
No, you're thinking of Raw Deal.
Oh. Okay.
Which is the next movie on the list.
Okay.
So, Commando, does that count for everybody?
Yes. Yeah.
So, does he just go around that whole movie wearing no underwear? What's the plot?
I guess that one person will give another LOL. pandering to an audience of one. So, Commando definitely counts, right?
Yes.
All right. So, now we'll go into Raw Deal, which is 86. So, all of these movies from 82... all the way to 85 so far are all basically almost all counting. So Raw Deal is the one I think with Radon Chong. That's the one where he's holding the guy and he says, I remember when I promised to kill you last, I lied, and he drops the guy. I forgot the guy's name. He was the guy from Dreamscape, the real weaselly looking guy.
Which one is the one where he says, ice to see you?
Oh, that's way down when he gets to Batman and Robin.
That was McBain that said that on The Simpsons.
By the way, good friend Michael Capehart says, don't let Bob speak anymore. Thank you, Mike. I appreciate it.
All right, so Raw Deal, we will count then, right? I think that one counts. Okay. I personally like that movie.
Okay.
All right, Predator in 87.
The Dwayne Harris story.
Look how smug you are yourself.
Are you purposely doing this? Because you know you have...
He's playing to the camera.
Yeah, why are you playing to the camera here?
Somebody gave me a laugh out loud.
This is not a green light for shtick. I don't come to laugh when it comes to the draft. Look, you need to get this shake laugh on camera. Okay, so Predator is...
Wow, Cal Richardson, I'm in love with Bob.
Oh, very nice.
Thank you, Cal.
So Predator is probably my favorite Arnold Schwarzenegger movie, if I were to rank them. Such a great movie, such a great storyline. All of the other great actors that were in that, Jesse the Body, Apollo Creed was in it.
How many governors were in that movie? Oh, you got Schwarzenegger,
you got
Jesse Ventura.
So Apollo Creed just needs to run and then make it a trifecta.
And comic writer, who I'm a big fan of, Peter David, said that in his mind, Predator is the perfect Tarzan movie. Hmm. That and I think when you watch it from that perspective, it gives it a whole different depth. I agree with you. Predator is an amazing movie. Really good stuff. Great. Yeah.
Yeah.
Wasn't Gary Busey in that?
Yeah, I don't think so. No, I'm pretty sure.
We need to do a Gary Busey how many.
Yes.
It wouldn't be a very long list, I'll tell
you. Whoa!
Wow.
DC Cab, and that's about it.
No, Lethal Weapon!
Gary Busey, Joshua. And then the Buddy Holly story?
Yes, he won an Oscar.
Okay, three. Okay.
All right, we'll talk about that.
Point Blank.
All right, so Predator counted, right?
Yeah.
The next one, 1987. So, 87, he had Predator and the greatness of The Running Man.
Oh, yes, Running Man.
Yes.
Running Man, love The Running Man, great movie.
Richard Dawson.
Has the great Maria Conchita Alonso in it.
Yes.
Yeah, it had Richard Dawson in it, where he tells him he'll be back, I'll be back.
Based on a Stephen King story, but yes.
And then I always like when he kills Jim Brown, and also when he kills the chubby hockey player guy, and he says, "Now here's your Sub-Zero, now... Plain Zero." And then when he kills Jim Brown, so Jim Brown is a guy that has like a fire extinguisher going around burning people up.
Fire extinguisher?
Or
you fire, mean flamethrower?
Flamethrower, whatever. And so his gas line busts, and Arnold Schwarzenegger walks up to him, lights up a match or something. "Hey, how about a light?" And blows up Jim Brown.
What? So I have a question. Was Running Man one of the first where they had the Arnoldisms, the quotes, you know, where, you know, was that kind of one
I
of the
I think
first
Terminator movie? Probably was the
well,
first
Terminator,
one.
No,
you know,
he really didn't have a lot of lines in Terminator.
I'll be back. Hasta la vista, baby. There's lots
well,
of...
Well, hasta la vista, baby came later in Terminator yeah. 2. In Terminator 1, his lines were pretty much,
I'll be back,
Sarah Connor. That's pretty much the extent of his line.
Well, I'm a fan of fake Schwarzenegger. Junior needs more fake Schwarzenegger.
I think we should have, from now on, Junior should do every how
is my fake Arnold better than the Dutch Ovens fake Arnold?
Yes.
So, in... I would say Predator, he had a couple of good lines like that, too.
Okay.
And then, actually, I want to say in Commando, he had some decent lines.
Okay, we'll have to check.
All right, so Running Man definitely counts, right?
Yes.
All right, so getting into 1988, he had Red Heat, which is...
Is it the one with John Belushi's brother?
Jim Belushi,
yeah. And he was playing like a Russian spy, policeman kind of deal. I thought the movie was pretty good, has good action in it. But I don't know.
It's kind of spare, buddy.
I wouldn't count it.
No. Okay, so we'll give that one a no. That same year, 1988, he also did one of his first comedy roles.
Yes.
In Twins, his first outing with Danny DeVito, which he would pair up with later.
Yeah, I would give the Twins a thumbs up.
Yeah.
I would give Twins a thumbs up, too.
Twins was, because not only was it a good movie, but you were surprised that this action star, this guy who can barely speak English... would have enough charm to carry that off. And then the whole premise of these two, you know, very different looking people.
Which I think ties into Game of Thrones currently with the Tyrion Lannister and Jaime Lannister.
Oh, okay.
So I think they could go back to Twins and get the original storyline.
Ah, nice. Okay.
Everything ties into everything.
Danny DeVito was Tyrion Lannister, coming soon.
So he went from 88 to 1990, so he took 1989 off. In 1990...
Was that when he was knocking up the maid?
Could be. This could be around the same time that he was giving the maid a little bit extra in tips. Just the tips. Total Recall in 1990, another great sci-fi action movie. Love Total Recall.
Yeah.
Also has a very young, the chick from Basic Instinct,
Sharon Stone.
Very young, hot.
Didn't she
Sharon
have three
Stone.
Boobs in that movie?
No, there was another lady that had three boobs in that movie. But yeah, I love Total Recall. You agree?
Yeah, that's good. Total Recall, solid. I give that a thumbs up.
Total Recall is one of, I think, truly great science fiction movies. You know, the whole premise of image upon an image, and you know, is this real? And the whole idea is this game you're playing, this virtual reality. I love the movie, and then I love reading the novelization of the movie too.
I didn't even know it was.
Yeah, it was.
A book, right?
I believe Orson Scott Card was the writer who did it, but I think that is a genius movie, and I haven't seen it recently, but I bet it would hold up.
Oh yeah, I've seen it recently, and it definitely holds up. Also, the end of it, when they're not able to breathe on Mars and their faces start going crazy, massive shake laugh. So if you want to laugh, get to the end of Total Recall.
His eyes are
and
popping.
His eyes, everybody's eyes and their tongues are sticking. Whoa, whoa. That is massive shake laugh. You need to stick around just for the ending there.
All right, very nice.
All right, so Total Recall, we will give a thumbs up.
Yes.
Also in 1990, he did another comedy role, Kindergarten Cop.
Yeah, that's solid. That's the one with the, no, it's not the tumor.
It's not a tumor.
So shout out to the audience. They called out Kindergarten Cop and they all, like people, it's not a tumor. Yeah, really funny, really sweet movie.
Yeah, who was the chick in that movie? The lead lady?
I don't remember. The blonde lady, I don't remember her name. The partner cop, right, is the one you're talking about?
Oh, wasn't it Pamela Reed?
Yeah, Pamela Reed was his partner, but the
teacher. Who was the teacher?
I don't remember. The principal is the lady that's now in the NCIS or something, right? She's short.
Linda Hunt?
Yes, and she played the principal.
Oh, Mike's sister.
Yeah. And then
Mike who?
I love the scene, like, how did it feel when you hit that obnoxious parent? It felt good. I knew it. You know, she's so happy and such.
All right, so Kindergarten Cop definitely counts, right?
By the way, Kenny Moore. Hey, Kenny. It's okay. So he's doing his
junior. Oh, so he's
nice.
Doing a mini.
It's okay.
Penelope Ann Miller, someone just said.
That the girl from Boardwalk Empire? Darmody's mom?
No, Darmody's mom was Gretchen Mol.
Oh, I get them confused. Okay, so Kindergarten Cop counts.
Yes.
1991, his highest grossing movie.
True Lies?
No. A sequel.
Oh, Terminator 2.
Terminator 2,
Electric
Judgment
Boogaloo.
Day. Probably my second favorite Arnold Schwarzenegger movie.
It was better than first Terminator.
What?
Absolutely.
That
was 1991.
So, I was
so
working
smooth.
At Bang Tech at the time.
Wow, that
and,
far back?
Yeah, and Doug Akins and I snuck out of work.
Oh, Mark Spire, are you listening to this, Mark Spire?
And, I had not seen the first Terminator, but I was amazed. You know, that was really, in a lot of ways, the first CGI, you know, the whole
Terminator. The Meltoy Terminator.
Oh, yeah, that was really good CGI. The liquid,
it was,
yeah.
And it was just a
great. And it had the Guns N' Roses song.
Yeah, You Will Be Mine, which is one of Guns N' Roses, probably 10, maybe 12.
Oh, Gary Argy.
Yeah, Gary's going to rage up about that, too.
They have two.
Oh, wow. Guns N' Roses.
Wow.
You mean two albums? Or
no, two hits.
Wow. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Gary's really going to rage up.
Yes, indeed.
So that will be a future how many.
Okay. Good.
All right. So Terminator 2 definitely counts, right? Great movie. One of the greatest movies of the 90s, I would
say.
Yes,
I agree.
All right.
I got too much Cloverfield cam on this thing. I'm ping-ponging back and forth.
All right. So from 91, he takes 92 off. Going into 93 is a okay movie. Last Action Hero.
Is that the one with Damon Wayans? No, that's The Last Boy Scout.
Yeah, that's an Adam Sandler Damon Wayans, isn't
no,
it?
No, that was The Longest Yard was Adam Sandler. Last Boy Scout.
Who was the other guy in
maybe
The
he
Last...
was. I don't remember.
I want to say it was.
But
maybe it was Bruce Willis.
Yeah, it was
and
Bruce
Damon
Willis.
Wayans.
But it wasn't Arnold Schwarzenegger, wasn't it? I always get those movies confused.
No,
but
The Last
Action,
Hero's
the movie, the big ticket.
Yeah,
movie.
Where he's like an actor come to life or something.
Yeah, the premise is this young kid goes to, you know, magically goes to a world that is based on the physics and all the logic of TV.
So it's Arnold Schwarzenegger's Purple Rose of Cairo, basically, out of the screen and ooh, look at
Woody Allen movie,
hey.
Right?
But, okay.
Is that your fake Woody Allen?
No, that's my fake Terry Bradshaw. But
who had Woody Allen and Arnold Schwarzenegger combo on the trifecta? Because I think that would be a big win. Because I don't think anyone had that. I liked
Last Action Hero.
Yeah,
I liked
it
too. I mean, it wasn't his best movie.
It was pretty graphic. Marlon Brando and that chick just going at it the whole movie. That's Last Tango.
That's not even man. That's just a stretch. Like not even close. They both have the word "last" in it. Man. Okay, so we're gonna give Last Action Hero get a shot of that. Last Action Hero is a yes. All right, so also in 93, there he was in two movies where he played himself. Beretta's Island, never heard of it. Any of you guys heard of that?
Is that where Robert Blake goes on vacation?
No.
All right, you know, Bob, do I need to just keep the camera on you?
No.
It's like Junior's the one talking, and then you give us comedy.
That's my role. Okay. That's my role. I'm supposed to fire off one-liners.
And also in 93, he was in the movie Dave as himself, but so, I think that was a cameo.
That's the one where Kevin Kline's the president, right?
I believe
Which
so.
Which is a good movie, but I would not count it for Arnold Schwarzenegger. By the way, my partner, one of my co-hosts, in one of my real podcasts,
that's good shit.
Christine says she has a drinking game for Last Action Hero.
Oh,
so I think she needs to send that to
us. Yeah, email that to us.
Yes,
we thrive on feedback.
Yes, indeed.
All right, so 93 outside of Last Action Hero, he didn't really have a lot going on. Going into 94. His third highest grossing movie.
Oh, I'm sorry. Christine said, that's kind of mean.
The real podcast.
Wow. She has no idea of our relationship.
Christine. One of your friends, Christine.
Yeah, Christine. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, she's does Game of Thrones with me, and she also did the American Gods podcast.
It's not the demonic car.
No.
Okay. So, the Stephen King movie?
Yeah. Why did it take you a
Stephen? Yes.
Okay, so True Lies in 1994, third highest grossing Arnold Schwarzenegger movie. Counts? Doesn't count?
Yes. In spite
with
of
Jamie Lee
in
Curtis?
In spite of Tom Arnold, it counts.
What do you mean? He was the comic relief.
Kind of like I'm the comic relief.
And it also had Bill Paxton with a lot of panic. Oh, okay.
So I took Poochie to see Last Action. True Lies. You know, and there's a scene where Jamie Lee Curtis is in the black dress and everything, and I'm like, why am I don't care that Chris sees all this blood and violence and blowing up, but this kind of risque scene.
One
I'm
nip,
like,
and it's oh my god.
Go. I've always been a big fan of Jamie Lee Curtis. I have a crush on her, and it was a really
although she
good
was
movie.
Born as a man. So.
I don't care. Yeah.
So I guess you could say that was the first tranny porn scene on Big
Sir.
Porn.
That's not the. That's that not, is an, not that is not an acceptable term, sir. That is not
okay. So True Lies definitely counts, right? Also, in 1994, he again teamed up with Danny DeVito, their second partnership together. And did the movie Junior, which is named after me.
It doesn't count for that reason alone. It does not count.
So I obviously have a bias towards this movie because it was made specifically for me. This is the movie where I believe he's like a man that's pregnant.
Yes.
And trying to have a baby.
Emma Thompson's in it, I think, right?
So would you guys say that
too
one
too much
counts?
Of a twins?
Yeah. No, yeah. I think it counts, though it is not one of my favorite movies. I think
but we've all heard
yes,
of it.
Absolutely.
We've all probably seen it.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to give that one a yes. All right, so he goes from 94 to 96, so he took 95 off, and did Eraser, which I believe is with Vanessa Williams, where he's like a marshal or some kind of policeman trying to protect Vanessa Williams.
So this is when he's starting to go through a slump in his career, in my opinion.
Yeah.
I don't think that's a very good movie.
So was it a pick based on that 80s dance pop band?
Erasure.
Oh, Erasure. Okay. I couldn't recall what...
Oh, my goodness.
Or the David Lynch movie.
Oh, Erasure.
Not
Erasure
Head. Yes. So Erasure, if Arla's watching this, they have like 10, right?
They're no Pet Shop Boys.
Dang it. No Depeche Mode. All right, so Eraser counts?
Yeah.
So good friend Greg Paula, I've forgotten half these movies. Thank you, Greg.
Worth a revisit.
The purpose. That's worth the
definitely
podcast.
Worth a
Thank
revisit.
You.
So I'm going to say yes on Eraser.
Okay.
The next movie he did in 96, Jingle All the Way, another comedic movie. I believe that's the one where they're fighting for the doll and the toy store.
Him and Sinbad are fighting.
Yeah.
Out.
But Jesse's definitely right. He's going into a downward spiral at this point.
Yeah, you can't count
so
that.
Many great movies in the 80s and early 90s.
I didn't put...
So,
I didn't...
You're saying no.
Yeah, I didn't put up a fight on Junior.
I will say no on Jingle All the Way.
Okay, and Christine votes no.
Good. All right, so consensus rules on this one. So we'll give that one a no.
Kenny.
Yeah.
Hell no. Awesome. So very good.
I like this. I like this instant feedback. We need to go live for every episode.
Yes. Sir.
Maybe next time it needs to be in P1CR so they can call us SG and make fun of you.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. So 97. We're getting into.
I'm sorry. Make okay, Michael K. Park. This is his pay the bills period.
Just taking whatever role he can, and he probably played a lot of bills with this next role, which is probably considered the worst comic book movie of all time, or definitely one of the top worst ones, Batman and Robin. And again, this is where he said, "Ice to meet you." So I kind of want to count it just because it's so iconically bad.
Yes.
I guess it's kind of a big role.
Keep this in mind. It did make $107 million in the box office.
Is this one a Val Kilmer or George Clooney?
George Clooney.
This was the only George Clooney, and George Clooney made the joke once when they were doing the Ocean's 11. You know, they were doing some kind of press thing, and someone talked about destroying, and he goes, "Look, I killed the Batman franchise. Nothing, you know, nothing as bad as that."
It also
and Chris O'Donnell was in it?
Yes, and it also had the very hot Uma Thurman in it.
So Chris O'Donnell was in this one and Son of a Catwoman?
Okay. All right. We'll remember this. We'll remember this whenever you're doing your topic.
Yes.
All right. So Batman and Robin
Kenny,
is a
bat
yes.
Nipples, right. It is a movie I have not rewatched. I do remember it painful. Isn't that when you had the Batman credit card or something? I mean, this was not a good Batman movie, but I do agree.
But if you look at it from a comedic point of view, even though it wasn't trying to be funny, I think it's worth being on this list.
Yes.
Just because everybody knows it. There's all kinds of YouTube videos of all of the scenes that Arnold Schwarzenegger was in and all of his one-liners, which we probably should add in post.
Okay.
At some point.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you for giving me more words.
you want to get a shot of the speaker, the PSA...
Okay.
Because Bob booked the wrong room.
I booked the one you told me to.
Well, you know this library better than I do.
No, I
practically
don't.
Live here. Okay, so getting from 97 to 99, he does the movie End of Days.
I don't even remember that one.
I kind of remember that one, but not really. Do you remember that one at all, Jesse?
I know it was something to do with, you know, the end of the world and time. I
yeah,
just don't
like the devil is like trying to bring the end of the world or something like that. I want to say it has Gabriel Byrne in it.
Yeah, I agree.
From Talking Heads?
No, it's David Byrne in it.
Yeah.
Okay, so End of Days, we're going to say no?
Yeah, I'm going to say no.
Okay. Then he goes in 2000 and does The Sixth Day. So his trilogy has begun.
So this is a clone movie, right?
I want to say, yeah, I don't even remember this one.
I don't remember much. I don't count it.
Bob?
I never saw any of the first 5 days. So
okay,
I'm not
you're useless
it.
In this topic at this point. So, all right, so now we're getting into 2001. He has a voice role in Dr. Dolittle Part 2. He's a wolf.
I didn't know he was in that. Really?
Yeah, he's the white wolf.
It doesn't count.
Okay, so 2002, he does a movie called Collateral Damage.
Yeah,
you
I remember
guys
that.
Remember that one?
For some reason, that was striking me as a Van Damme movie. Does he have one that's similarly named to that?
I want to say he has one called Something Damages or Carpet Damages or something like that. But I wouldn't count this one. I would have a hard time not getting talked into this one. So we'll give that one a no. All right, so now he gets back to the winning formula. He's gone a couple of years with some duds. And he is reaching out to the Terminator franchise and makes Terminator 3 Rise of the Machines, his second highest grossing movie. Now, this is the one where they had the girl Terminator come back, and he's helping, Sarah Connor, the son.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's the son's name? Something Connor?
John?
John Connor. He's helping John Connor try and stop the end of the world. Skynet is already taking over. Do you guys count this one? I do.
I remember seeing that. I think we saw it on a big Bang Tech, you know, movie night.
Oh, really?
I think so.
In base?
Yeah, and I remember liking it because it kind of tied up at the end of the movie. You know, John's got this, you know, John Connor, this is John Connor, and I'm the voice of resistance. And I remember it was really, it felt like it was a good kind of ending to the trilogy. Like, okay, now we're set up to kind of go forward to the first one.
So, oh, the ending is really depressing. Like, you think that he is able to stop Skynet from destroying the world, and all you realize is he just got placed into a bunker to watch the world get blown up. Him and Claire Danes is the girl.
Oh,
in
yeah,
it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, so Terminator 3 does count?
Yes, absolutely.
All right, so in 2003, he was also in the movie The Rundown, where he was just a cameo role. I wouldn't count that one. I don't think that he was a star in that. Okay.
So.
Around the World in 80 Days. Do you remember that movie? Him being in that movie?
No.
Nope.
No.
2005, The Kid and I, which was a cameo role.
No, no cameos.
Okay.
Scott wants to know, can we go back to The Running Man?
We can revisit that later.
Yes.
All right, so 2009, this one may be a little controversial.
Okay.
2009, he again dabbles in the Terminator franchise, and he is in Terminator Salvation, which is the one with Christian Bale, but he is CGI Arnold. If you remember at the end of Terminator Salvation, a brand new version of the Terminator is in one of the bunkers or something, and he comes out looking all young and new and fresh, just like he did in the first Terminator movie. So he's in it, but he's CGI Arnold.
No, it isn't.
So it doesn't count? Okay, I will not argue that one.
By the way, Mr. Capehart said this is his pay for the divorce period. Thank you, Michael.
All right, so 2010, he has a small role in the first Expendables. And if you remember that, that's when they meet up in the church, and he says hi to basically Sylvester
Stallone. I mean,
that
was a big movie. That's a really big movie.
But
he's barely in it.
He's just there basically.
That one counts more as a Stallone movie.
He's just there to kick Stallone in the nuts. Oh, you really like the forest. Oh, and that's pretty much it. So I'll give that one a no. But in 2012, he was in Expendables Part 2, and in this one, he does have a pretty big role.
Okay.
He does do a lot of killing, a lot of shooting. Great action movie. All of the Expendable movies were great action movies.
I am proud / embarrassed to admit I've never seen an Expendable movie.
You should. They're fun popcorn
movies.
Yeah, they are very fun, very entertaining movies. Okay. A lot of action. I would count Expendables Part 2.
Okay.
Would you agree?
Yeah. And they probably are like the most expensive cast ever when you think about everybody that's in those things.
All right, so now we're getting to really the bottom of the barrel of his career at this point. 2013, he was in a movie called The Last Stand, where he played Sheriff Ray Owens.
Oh, that was a Johnny Knoxville.
Yes, and I was going to say his co-star, Johnny Knoxville. So he's teaming up with the guy from, whatchamacallit, what's the name
Jackass.
Of the show? Jackass. Does it count? Does it not count?
I didn't see
it. I've never seen it. I know you want to count it because of Johnny Knoxville, but
I do love me some Jackass.
Okay, so that's going to be a no.
Okay.
In 2013, he also starred again with Sylvester Stallone in a movie called The Escape Plan.
When they were in that
they're
space
in that
prison.
High-end space prison.
Yeah.
Sylvester Stallone is like a prison designer, and he has to break out of the prison, and Arnold Schwarzenegger helps him. So, obviously, these team-ups with Sylvester Stallone came 30 years too late.
Yes.
Had they been happening in the 80s, this movie would have garnered millions upon millions, but it only garnered a paltry $25 million.
Yeah, it wasn't that great of a movie.
So, no?
Yeah, I say no.
All right, so we will give thumbs down on that one.
Okay.
2014, he was in a movie called Sabotage, which is a movie I saw where he is like part of a federal drug agency group.
No dice on that one.
I saw it, but yeah, it was not that great of a movie.
That's because you see everything.
He really does.
Yeah, anything action related, I'm in. But that movie, I'm not surprised nobody else saw it. Only made $10
million. Kenny says it sucked. Thank you, Kenny.
It only made $10 million in the box office.
So it was really career sabotage.
All right, so 2014, he also was again in the next Expendables movie.
James Ryder said that it was a Beastie Boys biop.
Ah, yes. I almost made that joke, but I'm glad
that
it got better
James.
Reception. Yes.
All right, so 2014, he was in Expendables 3. Again, he has a pretty large size role in that one, so I would count that one. Would
I kind of feel like if
that?
You count one, you got to count all of the Expendables.
That
and
he at least had a decent role
playing,
in it, yes. So I'm going to give that one a yes. 2015, he was in a movie called Maggie, which I've never heard of, never seen. So I'll give that one a thumbs down. He also
about
produced
Homer's
that movie.
Baby?
Really? You gonna own that one?
Yeah, I'll own that one.
Okay.
All right, and the last movie on the list, thankfully, again, he reaches out to the Terminator franchise and makes Terminator Genisys.
This one counts.
This is the one that has Khaleesi as Sarah Connor.
Oh, okay.
And I thought it was a pretty good movie. I would give this one a thumbs up.
Mother of
I
Cyborgs.
I think this one counts.
Mother of Cyborgs. I like that. Yes. Okay.
All right, did you see that
breaker
one?
Breaker of Circuits. Hey, Breaker of Circuits.
That's your nice. Stick. Okay, I'll give you a thumbs up on that one.
Okay.
All right, so if we count up all of the yeses,
yes.
Let's see what our final total is. A lot of no's, a lot more no's than I thought there was going to be. 22 yeses.
Oh, Jesse wins the showcase showdown.
Yes. Jesse definitely
I
wins
was
the 20. Showcase showdown.
Yes, Scott Compton, we did talk about when he was pregnant. Sorry you guys are late. So thank you guys for joining us. This was an experiment. We usually just do a few minutes, but we appreciate you guys joining us.
So before we sign off, do you want to make some guess? I know we kind of touched base on some of the highest and lowest grossing movies. So we talked about Terminator 2 being the highest grossing movie. It made $204 million.
Wow.
Which in 1991 was a lot of money.
Yes.
In compared to $204 million now. His next highest at $150 million, Terminator 3, which was done in 2003. But surprisingly, his third highest
True
grossing
Lies.
Movie was True Lies.
Yeah.
I would have thought it would have been Total Recall.
But yeah, True Lies was really good. By the way, Michael Capehart says we should do this every time.
I want to do it every time.
Every
yes,
so.
I like it.
Okay, good.
Dang it.
So do you want to guess of the movies we talked about what his lowest grossing movie was that we said yes to?
Oh, we said yes to. I was going to say Maggie. But, but
of the ones we said yes to.
Of the ones we said yes to, probably Junior.
Okay.
Jesse? I'm tempted Junior, too. I was going to think that maybe Jingle All the Way?
I think we said no to Jingle All the Way.
No, we said, yeah, we did say no to Jingle All the Way. But
okay.
Jingle All the Way made $60 million.
Okay.
Junior made $36
million. Okay.
His lowest grossing yes movie, Raw Deal, $16 million.
Boy, he dated. That studio got a raw deal.
So, yeah,
yeah
the
yes.
studio.
They probably had to pay Schwarzenegger
absolutely.
About $20
million. An extremely raw deal.
Yes.
So, all right, so that's our list.
Yeah, thank you guys. We appreciate it. Just Michael wants to know, what did Running Man make?
Running Man comes in at $38 million, which in 1987 was probably
okay.
a pretty
okay.
decent amount of money.
All right.
Richard Dawson commanded about 30 of that.
All right. So this is, we thank you. This is, we appreciate you guys listening to us. We may do this again. This was fun. So I am Jesse Jackson. You can find me on Twitter at Jesse Jackson DFW. Bob?
Yeah, I am at Lukewarm Tallboy.
It's a
Twitter.
Funny story.
Yeah,
yeah, we don't talk about
it. And you can reach me at Metzkin Junior, Metzkin _ Junior on Twitter. You can also email me if you guys actually still use email at MetzkinJunior@hotmail.com or gmail.com.
So thanks, everyone.
All right,
talk
thank
to you.
Soon.